So this is lecture number 3 of center of mass. In the previous lecture we had discussed about velocity of center of mass, acceleration of center of mass, and I had also said that there are two types of forces, internal and external, right? Okay, so we had derived this equation, velocity of center of mass m1 v1 plus m2 v2 upon m1 plus m2 for two particles, right? And acceleration of center of mass m1 a1 plus m2 a2 upon m1 plus m2. Okay, so now before starting our discussion of internal and external forces, we'll solve one or two questions based on this concept, this formula, and then we'll see what is internal force, what is external force, right, and how internal force does not contribute to the motion of center of mass. Okay, so see, there is a pulley, massless string, say a mass of 2 kilogram is tied at one end of a massless string, and at another end let us say mass of 1 kilogram. Here see, two masses are tied at the end of a light inextensible string. One is of 2 kilogram, another is of 1 kilogram. Okay, you have to find acceleration of center of mass. Acceleration of center of mass given g is equals to say 10. See, this kind of question definitely you must have seen in laws of motion. Okay, so we are to find the acceleration of center of mass. First of all, we are not knowing the acceleration of two bodies. That means this 2 kilogram will go with certain acceleration A, the same 1 kilogram will go in upward direction with the acceleration A. We'll first find the value of this acceleration. Okay, see, so in this we'll use the formula, let us say this as m1, let us say this as m2. Okay, so definitely this formula you must have studied in laws of motion, m1 minus m2 upon m1 plus m2. Of course we can derive this formula, mg minus t equals to ma, t minus mg equals to ma, and then if you are adding two equations you will get this equation. Okay, so acceleration of this two individual body will be m1 minus m2, so 2 minus 1 upon 2 plus 1 into g. So acceleration is 1 means g by 3, so that is 10 by 3. Okay, so this means that 2 kilogram is coming down with an acceleration of 10 by 3, and 1 kilogram is moving upward with an acceleration of 10 by 3. Okay, now we have to find the acceleration of center of mass. Okay, so using the formula, acm is equals to say m1 a1 plus m2 a2 upon m1 plus m2. Since both of them are in opposite direction, one acceleration will be taken negative, one can be taken positive. So m1 is 2 into 10 by 3. I have taken downward acceleration is positive, so upward acceleration will be negative, minus 1 into 10 by 3 upon total mass, which is 3. Right? So actually I have used the formula m1 a1 minus m2 a2, no problem. So ACM is equals to 20 by 3 minus 10 by 3 upon 3. So this will be 10 by 9 meter per second square. This is acceleration of center of mass. Clear? First of all, see, we had calculated the acceleration of individual object, individual block, right? And then using the formula, ACM equals to m1 a1 plus m2 a2 upon m1 plus m2. This is how we will calculate the acceleration of center of mass. Okay, see, let us solve one more question. See again another question. This is a body of mass 2.5 kilogram and various forces are acting on the body. That is what is shown in the figure. You have to find the acceleration of center of mass, ACM. Acceleration is a vector quantity, so we have to find both the magnitude as well as direction. This is the solved example given in H.C. Verma. Okay, see, this x axis is y, these are the forces. We'll use vector vectors concept over here. We'll first of all resolve these forces in x and y direction, and then we'll add x component and we'll add y component. Okay, so let us say this as f1. So f1 is equals to already x component, f1 of x, or we can direct write f of x, no problem. Since it is in negative x direction, f1 of x, so it will be minus x. About this, let us say this as f2. This was f1. So this is 460, so this will be 4 cos 60, 4 sin 60, right? So f2 x will be 4 cos 60, so that is 4 by 2 newton. Okay. Let us say this as f3, so this will be cos 53, sin 53. Okay, but we are to take only the x component. So f3 of x is equals to 6 cos 53, right? So degree, so 6 into cos 53, that will be triangle 3 by 5. So this will be nearly 18 by 5. X component. One more force is here, 5 newton, it is given this way, 5 newton, this is 37, so this will be cos 37, this will be sin 37. Okay, so it is towards positive x direction, so it will be positive, so this will be 5 cos 37, 5 sin 37, right? So f 4 of x will be 5 cos 37. So 5 cos 37 will be 4 by 5, right? So this will be 4. So this is how we will calculate the x component, right? So now I have resolved the forces along x direction and I have written the values. Now we'll resolve the force in y direction, sigma f of y. Okay, so f1 is not having any y component, right? So f1 y will be 0, f2 y will be 4, it is in positive y direction, so it will be 4 sin 60, so that is 4 into root 3 by 2, 2 root 3, 2 into 1.73. okay, that is fine. Now what is y component of third force? It is 6 sin 53, but it is in negative y direction, so we will write as minus 6 sin 53. See, this is 6, this is 53, this will be cos 53 which is positive and sin 53 which is negative, so that is minus 6 into 4 by 5. This will be minus 24 by 5. Okay, fine. Then this will be 5 sin 37, which will be positive because it is in vertically y direction. Okay, so 5 sin 37. So it is 5 into 3 by 5. Okay, so this will be 3. Now you have to add all the x components. So force in x direction will be minus 6 plus 2 minus 4 minus 4 plus, okay, minus 4 plus 4 will be cancelled, so it will be 18 by 5. Clear? See, minus 6 plus 2 minus 4 minus 4 plus 4 cancel, so it will be 18 by 5, right? So this will be 3.6 by 3 to 15. Here, similarly add y components. So it will be 2 root 3 minus 24 by 5. What is 24 by 5? 5 fours are 20. 4.8, right? And this is 3. So it is 2 root 3 minus 4.8. 2 root 3 minus 4.8 plus 3. So this is 3.46 minus 4.8 plus 3. 6.46 minus 4. Clear? 2 root 3. I place the value of root 3 as 1.73 and multiply it by 2. So this will be nearly 1.7. Clear? So this is how we find the x and y component of the force, f of x and f of y. So the net force F on the body will be, see, f of x is positive. So f of x will be here. Right, this will be f of y, this will be a bit shorter, f of y, this is the result, let this be the angle theta. So net force F will be root of f of x square plus f of y square. So that is say 3.6 the whole square plus 1.7 the whole square, 16. So this will be nearly, we can say it as 4 newton, under root of 3.6 whole square plus 1.7 whole square. Okay, so this is what is force. Now we are to find acceleration. Okay, so before that let us find the angle, tan theta in this triangle, fy by fx, right, f of y opposite by adjacent. What is f of y? 1.7 upon 3.6. Right, so if it would be 34, it would be 0.5, so this would be 0.4 something. Okay, so this is tan theta, that means we have found the direction of acceleration. And finally, ACM will be net force upon mass. What is mass of the body? It is given as 2.5. Acceleration comes out to be 1.6. So this is how we will find the acceleration of center of mass. Here we just have resolved the forces, we have resolved the forces in x and y coordinates, and then we have added x components and then we have added y components, just as what we did in the vectors. Clear? This is how we will find the acceleration of center of mass. Okay, now see. Clear? Okay. Now we'll discuss about the internal and external forces in our next video, right? That what are internal forces, what are external forces, how center of mass is affected by external force, and why center of mass does not, or why center of mass is not affected by internal forces, and we will solve few questions on the topic. Clear?